Hey everyone! So I'm back at my parents' house, fully moved. Everything that was in the other apartment that belonged to me is out of there and into here. We actually had to open public storage because honestly, it just wasn't going to fit in this room without it being super claustrophobic. It's really cramped in here right now. I forgot how small this room actually is. I want to say I'm adjusting well, but honestly, I'm not. I'm super overwhelmed right now, and I'm filled with so much sadness. It's pretty pathetic, honestly. You know, old feelings are just coming back, and it's just so frustrating because it took so much effort for me to even put on, you know, some eyeliner, turn on this camera, which, by the way, I've lost the battery charger to. I don't know where it is. I guess it must be in public storage, but I have to look through so much shit just to find it, because at the beginning of moving, I went to Home Depot with my mom and bought boxes, which was fine, but then I ran out of boxes. I bought 10 large boxes and I filled all of them up, and then my dad, he was too lazy to go back to Home Depot, and so he just said, no, just buy like garbage bags and stuff everything in there. And so I did that, and then he started complaining to me, like saying, oh, these plastic bags are breaking, why are you putting heavy things inside them? And it's like, you told me to put things in them. And what also made it complicated even moving here, and why it took an extra week, because it took an extra week. I actually moved out, the last day was April 7th when I was supposed to leave on the 31st, because he didn't want to hire movers. I guess he just has like a bias towards them or something, or maybe he just felt like the movers were going to steal everything, when hello, it's not 1994 anymore, it's 2017, and there's a lot more checks and balances than there were back in the day. So I don't know. And then he doesn't have a car, so he complained to me that he had to like hire his friends or something, or people to get a van and to move some things. Like, he used that van and those friends to move the bed, which is fine, but then drama aside, I'm here, I'm back here, and honestly, I'm a little miserable. It's a complete and total change. Like, you can see, like, the lighting's changed. I have to buy more lights and lamps just to illuminate this place better. The ceilings are a lot lower than the other place, so there's not much room here, and I feel like even if I were to, you know, organize everything into their own little space after I install like the cubicles and the shelves, it'll still feel pretty cramped in here, which is fine because I'm the only one living here anyway. And also, this bed takes up so much room. It's a Cali King. I feel like breaking this down, because it's a Tempur-Pedic, it's a Cali King, and it actually breaks up into two parts for some reason. So I just feel like keeping one part. And then what am I going to do with this mattress, because public storage actually isn't all that cheap. Even if I use it just to store this mattress, it's still an extra bill that I don't want to pay. I have some decisions to make. You guys want to see the pile that's right in front of me? It's pretty crazy. I bought that little panda 2 months ago. I had to. I don't know if you guys can hear the television in the background, but I'm sorry. You know, I live with people now, so they want their TV on and they want it loud. Of course, next time I'm going to let them know to turn down the TV volume, and we'll see how that goes. I did get to film what the apartment looked like after I moved everything out, which I will put in another video, but this is a quick update letting you guys know how I am. And I just need some support right now because this is making me really sad. When I first moved in, about an hour later, I fell asleep because I was really tired that day. I was just really, really tired and exhausted from everything. I barely had any sleep the day before because I'm the type of person where if I have something to do early in the morning, it's really hard for me to fall asleep because it stresses me out so much. Of course, you know, when you have a job that you have to wake up early in the morning for, you get used to it and you get over it and you find ways to fall asleep. But I have nothing that regularly requires me to wake up early. It's like the first day of school or something. I was trying so hard to not let it get to me, but I let it get to me. And it was so frustrating. Ugh. I didn't fall asleep until, like, I think like 7 in the morning. It was that bad, just because like I was just stressing myself out so much. And I started to revert back. I started to really think some crazy thoughts, so much regrets, like, oh, this could have been avoided had you done this and this and this for Desmond, you know, really depressing shit. But I have to stop thinking about all of that, because you know, what's done is done, the past is the past, and I have to get over it. And thankfully I'm still seeing counseling. Too bad it's only once a week, right? It's only like an hour max. Okay, so that's it. Thank you so much for watching and being patient with me as I go through this stupid move that I have to do. Maybe help me with some interior design tips, I guess. I'll update you all very shortly about any other new things that happen in my life. I don't think I'll be streaming this weekend. It's a little too hectic. I have to do a lot of interior design work. Yeah. All right. Enjoy your weekend, everyone. Bye.